Which legendary Reddit post comment can you still not get over? There was a post on RAWW of a gorilla using sign language to tell people not to feed it or something to that effect. To this day, I still laugh when I think about a comment that said, "It's a shame there's so many deaf gorillas." How useful and sadly how often I share this advice on insurance after a fire. I know other people have it saved as I'm not the only one who goes back to repost it, but it's invaluable in the aftermath of an emergency. It's not applicable to just fires. I shared this with friends who were brushed by a tornado that went through earlier this year. Whoever wrote that did many people one hell of a service. This one guy was on the toilet, and he sneezed while he was taking a sh. That same moment, the power in his house went out. He proceeded to cry because he thought he sh himself blind. Not a single post but a series by YushTimeOrf making up bogus facts relevant to any particular thread and ending with. Since 1998 when Undertaker threw mankind off Hell in a Cell and plummeted 16 feet through an announcer's table. Maybe someone can help me find the actual post. It was from 5 years ago on a post about what you would do with a specific amount of money, like $5 million in a lottery. Someone replied with, "Is that enough to rent an orange cat for 2 years?" And it was so far out of left field and hilarious to me that I haven't stopped thinking about it. That time a person on our Formula 1 asked if you could eliminate a race within the year, which would it be, and why, which looked rather bad when taken out of context, especially in our all. Haven't seen this posted yet, so I'll add this dude's 4 rules for getting your sh together. Someone in our homeowners trying to get rid of ants in their house. Tons of comments. One fellow Redditor suggested maybe there were no ants, that they were hallucinations due to carbon monoxide poisoning. OP had his house tested and turns out there were, in fact, no ants, and he was hallucinating them due to carbon monoxide poisoning. Till carbon monoxide can make you see ants. I can't remember everything about the post or even which sub it was in, but I think about this one a lot. OP was staying in a hotel and the person in the room next to them was blasting Sesame Street. They suddenly heard a grown man yell, "God damn it, Mr. Noodle." Every account on Reddit is a bot except you. Believe I saw it on Reddit. A RedTech related post. Guy starts a new job as a system admin. No other it at the place. Previous admin had been there for just about f-ing forever and left behind some documentation, but not enough to make the job easy. The guy finds a note from the previous tech with a few misctips, and then says if there is a critical emergency and everything else has failed, there is a box in the server room behind the switch, open only as a last resort. Guy is there for a few years. Metaphorical fires get fixed. He learns the tricks of the place. But one day the server doesn't boot. Tries everything. Can't get it to work. All the files are there. The company can't function. Actual fires are about to start. Guy freaks out and remembers the emergency box and figures now should be an emergency and figures maybe the guy left access info to site backups or tape drives or some sort of disaster recovery and goes into the server room. Behind the switch is a box, pulls it out and opens it to find a bottle of tequila. I need the link to this one. This is amazing. Reminds me of an old story. The former president gives the new president 3 boxes and asks him to open one each time he is in a major crisis. When faced with his first crisis, he opens the first box and it says blame it on the previous administration. When faced with his second crisis, he opens the second box and it says blame it on the opposition. When faced with his third crisis, at almost the end of his term, he opens the third box and it says remake these 3 boxes and give them to your successor. I still love the Arshower Thoughts post. Going waterboarding in Guantanamo Bay sounds like a great time if you don't know what either of those things are. I can't find the post, but it was a man whose son was born evil. They knew it right away. Born in the 70s, I believe, when he, the son, was older. He tried to kill his baby sister, or something, and the mom started to beat him up. The dad left the room and waited until she stopped. She came out 20 minutes later and he said, "Is he dead?" She said, "My God, I hope so." They locked themselves downstairs for 2 weeks, listening to him move around a little bit here and there. After 2 weeks he left and they never saw him again. That was chilling. I worked 1 year with a student that sounds like that man's son. Random attacks out of nowhere. No smiles that weren't malicious. Graphic depictions of what he was going to do to me that went way beyond what a child like him should be able to envision. He was a first grader. Talked about the different ways his pets died. but looking nearly cheerful about it. I was injured several times that year. To this day I tense when I hear his name or anyone speak in the same distinctive sounding speech pattern he had. Think Hannibal Lecter with the ebbs and flows that are just a little jarring. I once ran into him at a grocery store and still won't go there. I'm afraid he's going to recognize my car even though I haven't seen him in 3 years. I was put on him because I was the only one who could keep him even a little bit in line. And that was only because I was willing to give him exactly 0 strikes. It was exhausting and I was seriously relieved when I got a different job. I've worked with kids who are a handful before. If you work with them close enough, you usually figure out what's triggering their behavior. Problems at home. Trying to fit in with a crowd, etc. Even if you didn't know, it usually became obvious when something was about to trigger them. You figured out Bobby clicks his tongue when he silent reads and Jake can't stand it and expressed his frustrations through slamming his hand on Bobby's desk and telling him to stfu. You make sure Bobby and Jake sit nowhere near each other and maybe invest in a white noise machine and you can work on figuring out that Jake's dad just left them. But not this kid. We could never find a trigger. A scenario outside school, nothing. We had experts come in to look at him and he'd suddenly be the most charming child on the planet. But before they made it to the parking lot, he'd be trying to bite us. We begged his parents to try to take him to a therapist or a doctor, but they just kept trying to change his diet. If this kid grows into a serial killer, I would not be shocked in the slightest. I occasionally Google his name just to see if anything had happened with him. The Ask Reddit, where drug dealers talk about having to turn their customers into child protective services. Got bleak. I forget the whole thing, but something along the lines of a guy had to go to a dinner with his wife's parents. Ate some edibles not realizing how strong they were. And he was sweating like a pig, claiming how spicy the food was. Then his wife was like, "We've only had the appetizer, bread and water." I have no idea how to get the link, but it had me in tears the first time. Trust me, it's way funnier than I make it to be. I tried really hard to find the original post, but I couldn't find it anymore. It was a post in Ramithi Hall where an Uber driver drove a girl to a restaurant where she was meeting her boyfriend. Before he dropped her off, he gave her a respectful comment. Nothing inappropriate and without any bad intentions. He was asking if he was the a-hole and the answer was no. The best part happened in the comments section where somebody asked if he was living in a specific city. He replied a little freaked out with yes. Turn out it was the stranger cousin that he gave the compliment to. After he dropped her off at the restaurant, she went inside to meet her boyfriend. However, it wasn't a nice night because he broke up with her. She told her cousin that the compliment that her Uber driver gave her some comfort or made her happy or something like that. The girl and the Uber driver then contacted each other through the cousin. I don't know what happened afterwards, but if somebody knows this post, I will give you a virtual hug if you could link it. Is it this one? Some people are skilled at finding old posts. Huh. The story of Ujasin Inhal is one of the saddest stories that I have read on the internet. If you guys don't know the story, Ujasin Inhal was a fellow Reddit user that posted his story regarding his wife's cheating with his neighbor on Our Relationship Advice. Our Relationship Advice told him that he will be better off divorcing his wife than to deal with her. A few days later, he posts something on Legal Advice to see how he can secure custody of his 2 children during the divorce. His wife, named Brandy Worley, found the Legal Advice thread. The same day she found the Reddit posts, she kills both kids to spite her soon-to-be ex-husband. Brandy then calls 911 telling the operator that she stabbed herself and her 2 children because her husband was divorcing her. The call was recorded with Brandy showing no remorse or emotion during the call. This whole situation was unfolding live on Reddit and 4chan. Brandy was given 120 years in prison with a jury saying she doesn't regret her decision not one bit. Link for the 911 call. This video explains the whole situation in great detail. Holy sh, that was much worse than I expected. What the F does not even begin to describe this. This 14-year-old kid in a RenSFW post when asked what he was doing there and he replied, "I don't go to work." I mean, they're not wrong. There was an Ask Reddit thread that said, "What do you think nobody in the world is doing right now?" Top comment was masturbating to me. Top reply was just rubbed one out for ya. Godspeed, sir. That one Redditor that spent his entire grandmother's inheritance on a Twitch streamer, thinking they were going to get married. Sir. The first comment is the transcription. Scrolled down instead of trying to read the blurry image. I found you after I needed you. There is cringe and then there is this F. And there at the end I thought he was wrapping up with a lesson learned on how to interact read PPL. I want to go 5 minutes back in time and make a better choice about clicking this link. So a while back there was a post I think on our Insanepiapla Facebook of a woman looking for a bus to hold 60 people for a church function and was so effing hostile and rude about it. In one post she says next, and for months on Reddit people were always saying next to everything, but it seemed nobody besides me remembers this and I can't find the post. I do remember this. Upvote for you. And bonus trip. It's for a church, honey. Next. The burrito rant. A guy ordered a burrito for takeout and took it home only to find they had wrapped it sideways. He wrote the most amusing angry letter. There's an absolutely amazing comment about grief coming in waves that has stuck with me for a very long time. I'm on mobile so apologies for the shtylink. But it's a beautiful read. The post where a woman is saying how her husband and Phil are prepping for her to die during childbirth even though she and fetus are perfectly healthy. They 100% were plotting to kill her and there not being an update has me scared for her. You morbid mummy 11. It's been 5 months. No updates. Talking about worst moment in life. A mother described the silence she was met with when she came home and saw the shoes of her husband and child. And was anticipating hearing their laughter playing. But found them dead in a murder-suicide. Tree bros who were speeding to meet an ambulance after a comrade was injured. A woman blocked them in and the friend inevitably died. Kevin. The world's dumbest student. I miss Kevin's antics and wish I saved that comment. The story of you spontaneous. It's shocking how little it took for him to turn into a full-blown heroin addict. But the documentation of their spiral was more convincing than any DARE program I could have thought of. Ooh, I know this one. I just saw it a few days ago and my god, it is a roller coaster. There was one that I've never been able to find again, but some guy insulted somebody and he replied with something like says the virgin with a 3-inch penis and provided links from the other guy's post history that proved both those assertions. It was an absolute burial, you love to see it. The man whose girlfriend buried his canned beans in the woods. My favorite response to that story is the guy with the metal detector who says I'll find those effing beans. I will not jeopardize the beans. Go to Armital Detecting and see if there is anyone in your area. DM me if you're near Denver. I'll find those effing beans. The noisy gobshy story. And the follow-up posts are very interesting. Funny. Well-told story then it takes a turn. Warning. Emotions. I've not seen that one before. It's supposed to have epic proportions, but that ending is a real punch to the gut. As soon as I saw the first reply from the wife, my stomach dropped, and now here I am, crying over a British man I never met. Holy sweet Jesus. I had read the original post yonks ago, but I hadn't seen any of the updates. Wow. Wow. Unfortunately I didn't save the post but it went like this. There's an owl in front of my window. An owl. UOL. UUL. Hoot hoot, there's a hooter in front of my window. Reminds me of a text I saw that someone got from a DoorDash deliver driver. This text conversation is related to a DoorDash order. Hey they all out of lasagna. 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 The Schgarfield eat. I watch the Woody Harrelson I'm here to talk about Rampart AMA debacle happen in real time. I think it's one of the only times I ever actually participated in an AMA as it was happening rather than reading the whole thing later. It was magical. The guy who always worked in being beaten by jumper cables by his father into every comment. You're a Jerseyman 10. I've been on the toilet for about an hour now and can't move my legs because of this post. The description of how rabies kills you. God yes that left a serious impression on me. It made me really question all the stray dogs I enjoy petting and feeding on my trip to India. Not so RAWW anymore. It's zombie bagel guy Reddit original or was that reposted from somewhere? The man who attempted to throw his steak out the window. His wife followed up with her version a little later. Link, husband's version. Wife's version. I remember some guy asked Reddit what movie really made an impact on their life. And some guy said Paul Blart, Mall Cop, and somehow every post from that point on would end up relating to Paul Blart. Even made some leaks into other threads. Wait, that's what that was about? I remember seeing Paul Blart, Mall Cop on the most random posts LMAO. A recent one. But that 40-something-year-old guy who bought like 5 Platon bikes to give to the family of his 21-year-old Eastern European wife because they told him it was tradition in their country. Excuse me, what? It's been deleted. But here's the Rem of Edit link. The guy on our Wall Street Bits who got blocked by the Fed on Twitter because he kept tweeting printer goes brrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr government entity to block you individually on Twitter is hilarious to me. Honestly, I think about it every time I'm having a bad day. The dude who took pictures of his own balls and electrocuted them to prove a scientific point. One time on our relationship advice, some guy posted a thread called "My 25M girlfriend 26F baked all the beans. Now I consider to end our relations. What do I do?" It's deleted now though, but I still have the full post. I discovered this in another one of these Askreddit posts, but honestly it's too good not to put here. Now without further ado, here it is. "Hello. My girlfriend and me have done dating for 5 months. I thought this girl is very good, and became of love with her. Yet even so, on this Monday, I come home and found she has baked all my beans. Yes, all. Oh brother. In my cupboard I store several bag of bean, to mix often to bake on some days. To have a bit of baked bean on my dinner, or, heck, a lunch too some days. But on the Monday I find this girlfriend baked all the beans. I say, 'Why do you bake my beans?' And she say something as I bakes them good to save time. So I bakes them all now. I am astonished and full of dismay. I say I can for not eat all the beans. She say she has froze many of the beans so as we can unfrozen the on a later day and eat some at a time. But, if a bean is frozen unfrozed, the very good and very nice flavor of bean is gone far. A bean is best if baked fresh as a Sunday pie, not to be frozen unfroze. I told my dear friend I am so sad of this, as to my opinion the baking of the beans and to freeze them has ruined all my beans. She say I am gone haywire by my enragement and sad manners, but I hates what she did to my beans. On the days before Monday I thought, 'Will we marry the girlfriend?' Well, it might be so, but now I am so sad she baked them beans. I am considered to end our relations and not be the boyfriend and girlfriend anymore. But, is my idea wrong? Could my girlfriend make promise to not bake the beans? I do not know what doing to do and how to feel forgiving on her. The yes, all, oh brother, kills me. But now I am so sad she baked them beans. This is the one that always gets me. I love how confidently he writes this like we have any idea what he is talking about. For some reason I thought that the girlfriend buried the beans, not baked them. That's a different, equally amusing post. OMG, I just laughed so hard. Thank you." The one where Ellen Powell was let go as CEO, and everyone was celebrating because she had banned off at PR Plahat. But then one of the other admins posted saying that Powell was one of the only people in corporate that didn't want to ban FPH, and that things were going to get worse from here on out. "The Iranian yogurt is not the issue here. He's not a hoarder. Now there are 2,100 cartons of yogurt in our apartment. Eh. Good God, how have not seen this one before. Likely to be invention, but such an entertaining read, ha ha ha. Reading through that, if I wanted to collect yogurt I'd dehydrate or freeze dry samples. I think a freeze drying machine is even in the ballpark of a new fridge too. His yogurt collecting hobby could have been 100% reasonable. But no. He had to have fresh stuff lying around rotting." The OG post was Christians. "What would you do if you died and instead of Jesus it was Anubis? Best comment ever. Nice fursuit Jeezy boy you Winchester 247. There was a post about how a guy closed an elevator door on a dad and son who were trying to make it. The guy thought he was pressing the open button, so he smiled at them the entire time it closed on them. The image of this is hilarious. So way back when, 2008 to 2009, some Redditor got very excited over his 2 AM chili and posted an extensive tutorial, in Philadelphia bell peppers style. Naturally, this became a meme. Concurrently, another Redditor posted nothing less than the life hack of the century. Freeze a block of water. Squirt shower gel on top. Freeze that, and now you have ice soap. TM. This was a fine enough goof. But the ARP's insistence that this was much more efficient than putting shower gel on one's body made it become a meme. So what happens when two memes are popular at the same time? Exactly. Someone froze a block of chili and rubbed their body with it, and achieved the coveted number one spot. This site is weird like that. Sorry, no links as I'm on mobile. Many thanks to whomever is willing to dig them up. The guy who secretly eats an entire pizza and chicken wings in his backyard while his wife sleeps. There was a post a month or so ago about a girl whose boyfriend kept telling her she smells bad no matter how undeniably good she smelled. Finally, he admitted that he was just telling her she smelled bad to keep her self-esteem low enough she wouldn't leave him. Then she immediately dumped him. What's worse, sadder, is the boyfriend admitted that his own father was the one who taught him to keep putting down a partner so they'd never leave. Yeah, like a sick cycle of abuse. The dude who had a girlfriend that struggled to quit smoking, so he decided to take up smoking for a month just so he could show her how easy it is to quit if you are totally dedicated to quitting. He still smokes 10 years later. She quit a long time ago. Reminds me of the Redditor who tried heroin on a whim and then became addicted. That story is the reason I will never try any hard drugs. AWW. Did somebody get addicted to crack? Charlie Mack. This post where the comments are edited to make op look really weird. Funny. Love that one. The Ala Galadvis saga, where the anti-Semitic boss and the Jewish woman who worked for her both posted separately about the same incident and love put two and two together. Original perpetrator post. Original employee post. This is the one where the Redditors put it together. You can find more conversation about the original posts here. Ugra pointed out the perpetrator's original post is here. I love watching LA threads that slowly turn on the OP as they figure out which one's actually in the wrong. Hate to break it to you, but I think you're an anti-Semite. UF Blue Shell's rant on our grilled cheese about what exactly a grilled cheese sandwich is and how the sub has gone straight to hell with all the pictures of what are technically melts. I think about it whenever I make a sandwich. Which is frequently. You're letting me live in your head rent-free, huh? Doesn't sound very healthy to me. You have a lot of roommates, so it can't be too great for you either, TBH. OP gets a notification from a smart camera that someone was at their door in the middle of the night, and the top, or close to the top, comment was simply "I don't like it." Also, Rick Astley's AMA. I should not have clicked the first one. Father deletes son's Minecraft world. Not sure if it's legendary, but I still can't get over it. I saw that one. Hurts so bad. Even from an outsider's perspective. If someone did that to my attempts at writing as a kid, I'd be absolutely gutted. My dad decided to come into my room and throw away everything but the furniture and my clothes. Twice. It didn't feel good. He also at one point decided I had too many tubs of stuff. They easily fit in my closet with lots of extra space. He informed me I had to empty out two of them. Later I realized it was just because he wanted to use those tubs himself for his giant hoard of sh that would never be used again. The guy who had an entire alternate life while in a coma. I think about this so often. Same. Every so often I'll find myself staring at an everyday object for a little longer than I should. Trying to notice the irregular perspective. My life is fine. But I'm still scared of waking up. I think about this story all the time. Every time something ordinary seems a little odd, I think my time has come to wake up. It honestly freaks me out. This one in legal advice, where a landlord kicked out their tenant for going on a business trip by plane about a month before the lockdown. In addition, she created a thread elsewhere asking to buy a gun. It was a bit disturbing. The guy who thought his landlord was stalking him and leaving notes in his apartment, only to find out that he was actually suffering from carbon monoxide poisoning. Original post on Ala Galadvis. Update. There's another one out there where a girl thought her boyfriend was drugging her because she was blacking out and she kept finding little red bumps on her skin, but she really had bed bugs and they were making her so sick she would lose huge gaps of time. I remember that one. That one was wild. Sounded like a movie script.